Alright, I'm just going to lead around with this rig. I'm not putting a rod out over the other side of the river with a right hand rod today. Not after what happened yesterday. That was the mistake I made. The risk of putting that rod over there. Looking back, now I realise three or four of the fish that I caught from this area have gone straight up river. So, mistake made. Didn't take into account the risk factor of it. So I'm going to put one up on the inside line. I've had fish from the inside line here before and I've seen them. So I'm just going to pop a boilie on my hook to protect my hook. And then I'm just going to lead around for a little while. See if I can't find some gravel or something like that on the inside line here. Just 5-10 metres down the bank, that'll do. And put something on that. And I better put some bait out over there as well. Well, you know what, I can't find any clear spots up on the side here and on this margin. I can't see any either. It's absolutely chocker with this stuff. This stuff grows on the bottom of the river Cam in clumps up to a foot or two or even more deep. That's why it was all coming down yesterday. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the right hand rod over to the middle, left hand, the middle rod to the left hand rod, and this one's going to become the right hand rod. And I'm thinking about moving the rods, orienteering the rods around a bit more and having it up there, because there's some clear spots up there. We'll have a look anyway. Well, there isn't actually any spots up there except right near the outfall, and it's too far up and I don't really want a rod going back up that way. It just wouldn't be right, and I have to move the rods around and all sorts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a popped up bait just up the margin here and just sprinkle a few baits around it. I'll put on a light 1 ounce lead as well so it doesn't go straight into the weed, and see how it goes. It's either that or leave it out. Let's just straight up this. Okay. Right then, baits out over on them two spots. I put a handful out over there, that's about 15-20 baits maximum, probably more like 15. Both baits went over nice and sweet, 2 ounce leads, 7 inches of IQ with a size 6 Gardner choddy. That's a straight point hook, unlike the quarter choddy, which is a beaked. So, what happened yesterday? Well, basically, I cocked up, didn't I? I'm pretty much over it now. You don't want to go losing fish, do you? Especially when it's this difficult to catch them sometimes. And at this time of year, you're only going to get a few more chances, really. Although, having said that, I think this river might fish throughout the winter. After last year, coming down here in the snow and seeing this ice free, I quite fancied it. So I might try and come down and get one out in the snow this year. That'd be good. If it starts to snow, I'll start putting bait in and we'll see if we can get a response. That'll be fun. Hopefully by then I'll have all my winter kit as well. So we're down here early today. What's the time? I mean, yesterday we didn't get here until about 1 o'clock or so. It's 10 o'clock now, so I've been here for a good half an hour or more. I left mine at about 9 or so, so yeah. So I'm going to give it as long as I can. That's however long the food run lasts for, and however long before I get bored. But I reckon if I haven't had one by about three, then you know. So it's Friday. Tomorrow I'll be down to put in a couple of 3 kilos of bait and just leave it for the weekend. I can't fish Monday because I'm working. Tuesday I can fish, I've got the day off. However, I've got a friend coming from America this week. She's already in the country and she's coming to stay with me next week because it's cheaper than a bloody hotel, I suppose. So I guess maybe my time will be a little bit short next week, but I'll keep putting the bait in anyway because she likes going for walks. So yeah. Okay, let's see if we can get one out today and not make any cock-ups. That's the most important thing. Right, everything's set up, margin rods out. I've put some chops out, I just broke the boilies in half and threw them out, and I'll sit on the weed a lot easier. Okay, I've balanced the pop-up one of these. Actually, it's a bottom bait, balanced bottom bait with a bit of foam on it. A couple of inches down on the IQ, I've got one of these little weights. It just sort of acts as a wafter. It's nice, I like it, much better than the debris floating down the river. I've got the bite alarm set up to high sensitivity. Seems to be a lot cleaner today. The water's not so coloured and there's nowhere near as much water coming through and hardly any debris at all, so it should be a lot easier day anyway. I have no idea how long the batteries are going to last today, but well, it says either debris or a bream. Bream just pluck at the baits a lot, and you get a lot of stabs like that. Normally if you hook something, the rod tip's knocking. I'll watch the tips. Well, I'm going to have to take that middle rod out and recast it, because it's almost certainly got debris on it. Either that or it's got a bream hung on the end. We'll see, shall we? Load of debris. Debris. It's bloody cold out here, I'll tell you. It's definitely winter. Well, it's almost 12 o'clock, so I've been here 2 hours. I normally reckon that if it's on and the fish are about, you know, you should get a run within a couple of 3 hours, really. Yesterday it was after a couple of hours, and I don't think I've waited more than a couple of 3 hours ever here. You know, if you get the baiting right, and they're always about pretty much, then you should get fairly quick fish, so... Yeah, and the camera's flashing at me. It's telling me the battery's dead. Now this is the big battery, and this should last. Well, the battery's getting cold, and this is the reason why. Hold on. This is the reason why the batteries aren't lasting very long. This is my big battery. The one I've got on at the moment is about a third that size, so I've probably only got a couple of 3 hours filming with these batteries, which is a bit of a bummer because it should be about 5 or 6. So I'm going to stick this in my pocket and warm it up, and with any luck it'll still hold enough charge for me to keep going. So because the batteries are not lasting on this, I'm gonna just do blog entries because I can't film it all the time. Otherwise, either I go or I don't get it on film. I've got some camera with me and take some pictures, but I want to get it on film if I can. Obviously, I'm not going to get the run and anything else on film, playing the fish, whatever, because I can't switch the camera on all the time. But what I will do is get another battery for this, and maybe get a little sock for the batteries as well, keep them warm. So back to the standard blog entry. We should have enough for the day now. Well, that middle bobbin's up again, and I've literally just cast it out, and we've got debris on it a lot again. As you can see, it's gone tight. So I'll leave it for about 10 minutes or so if I can, and then I'll put it back out again. So we're getting a little bit of debris coming down, but the funny thing is, it's only affecting that middle rod. And it's possible there's some bream moved into the swim over there and they're pulling out the baits, but yeah, it's not really like bream. They normally stab at it and it goes up and down, and, you know. So we'll see. Well, that's the middle rod again. Either we've got bream coming into that deeper part of the spot, which is where the middle rod is, and they're pulling at it, or we've got debris. Each time I hit it, of course, there's nothing there, and there is debris. So what I'm thinking of doing is recasting the right hand rod and the middle rod back over to that spot and reposition them. I'm not getting any debris on the left hand rod, you see, the right hand rod, which is over there. I don't expect to get any on the middle rod, but yeah, so it's a bit odd that the left hand rod, it's a bit odd that the middle rod's the only one going off when I've got two rods over there. You know, if I was going to get debris on the line, I'd probably get it on the right hand rod as well, and it's not happening, which makes me think that we might have some bream stabbing at the bait, grabbing hold of it, moving the lead, tightening the line. Now we've got one on the right hand rod now, and the left there, and the middle. This is why I have my rod tips high, so I can see them nodding. Yeah, I might recast those two rods in a minute. I've warmed up that other battery, put it back on, still out of charge, so quite obviously not getting it lasting as long as we want. No idea what this camera's doing. She's taking these pictures of me when I'm smiling. It's got this special setting on it. There it goes again. Every time I smile. There you go, and again, I've got to switch that off. Hold on. Well, the right hand rod's now gone up, and that's got debris on it as well. So, there you go. Sounds a lot worse than what it is. Right. Let's get those two rods recast. Well, I've just replaced those two rods. It definitely was debris on the line. Big clumps of weed. Like that there. So I've cleaned them both, recast them, repositioned them. Still, it's not as bad as yesterday. Yesterday I was having to replace them every 5 or bloody 10 minutes sometimes. It's ridiculous. But there you go, you know. If I was fishing the other side, it'd be a lot easier, of course, because I'd have the lines tight to the margins, flat on the bottom. Yeah, fishing over there's a little bit dodgy with that farmer. He's been putting signs up everywhere saying no fishing. always ignored it, to be honest with you. But there you go. So, I don't know what the time is. Let's have a look and see what the time is. I think it's 12:30, so I've been here a good 2.5 hours now. Hopefully we'll get something today, but if we don't, like I say, I'll put the bait in that I've got with me when I go, and I'll come back down again tomorrow and put a couple more kilos in for the weekend. I might pop back Sunday as well and put back in some, I will be popping back Sunday, see if it's gone at all, put some more in. It's costing me a bit, I have to say, in bait and time making it, but you know, if I can get one of these real beauties out of here, it will be worth it. But I can't afford to go losing anymore. So let's hope that don't happen anymore, eh? So like I say, I've been here a couple of 3 hours, and well, I've never found the morning period at this time of year to be that brilliant. Around about sort of late morning from lunchtime onwards seems to be the best time, so that's what I'll try and stick to in the future. I'll try and get down here for about 12, 1 o'clock. The days are getting shorter, so it gets dark at about 4:30 at the moment. Soon it'll be 4 o'clock, 3:30, whatever, so I'll adjust my times so that I've got 3 or 4 hours before dark. But obviously with the shorter sessions, I'll be able to film most of it, unlike today, which is a much longer session. I do hope one of those flies off though, I really do. I've certainly put in the effort.
Got one. Well, the rod that I didn't expect to go off, the left hand one, went off. And I just had a nice quick scrap, very quick, powerful scrap. Very nice mirror carp. I'd say that was a good double. Definitely. Very similar to the one I lost yesterday, actually. Okay. So we got our river cam carp. Brilliant. I'm well chuffed. We got a result. I didn't expect it to come from that inside rod, though. Right, let's get the sling and everything ready. Get it weighed. Get it photographed. Pucker. Oh, God, I'm so relieved. When that went off, powering around, it really did, but kind of knew it wasn't a huge one because it just moving around too quick. But yeah, right, let's get that out of the net in the retaining sling, get that rod sorted out. Yesterday's forgotten. Log time. Got myself an absolutely cracking mirror. Pretty typical for the size of the fish along the river cam here, which is sort of mid to upper doubles, low 20s. I'm not sure if I caught this one before, but it don't half look like fish I have. I'll quickly show you it. It's in absolutely perfect condition. Look at that. There you go. 19 pounds exactly. Hang about, we're a little bit too close to the camera. I'll just move back a bit, because it ain't a bad size one, is it? But I mean, this is a truly, truly wild fish. You know, this hasn't been stocked. It's not fed on a constant supply of boilies. It feeds naturally. And it's absolutely perfect. It's got a little bit of damage here and there. I'm going to treat that with propolis before I put it back in. What I'll do is I'll put the fish back in the retaining sling and treat it while it's in the water. Right, I'll get some pictures of it. I'll just show you it again. Thins up or what? How about that? Not bad, is it? Well chuffed. Well chuffed. Okay. Let's get some pictures, shall we? then I feel better. I feel a lot better now. Yeah, that fish really did look like something I caught before. But I love these mirrors that you get out of here. They're all pretty different. And they're all amazing condition and amazing looking as well, you know. They're really, really lovely fish. So I'm well chuffed. I'll have a look when I get home at the pictures that I've got and see if I can't recognise that fish. Yeah, I feel a lot better. I was really surprised that it came to the inside line. That was my very first fish came to the inside line here. In fact, just down here. In fact, I was fishing further up near the sewer outfall, and I was fishing down here somewhere. I caught a common. I think it was 18 pounds something, something like that. That was back in 2004, and I'm still waiting to see if I've caught any of those fish from then. Last year I didn't catch any of the fish from 2004. They were all the fish that come from the backs. So I'll be interested to see which one that is. It wasn't bully, and it wasn't bully yesterday. That fish that I had yesterday looked very, very similar to that one. Very similar. Similar size, so upper doubles, low 20s. But yeah, I've forgotten about yesterday's now, or the pain of it anyway. I haven't forgotten about it, but the pain of it's gone, as it always does when you catch the next fish. So I'll be putting some bait on this inside line from now on, that's for sure. So we've got 3-4 hours fishing left, and you know what, we could have another one, couldn't we? I do hope so. That wind is really coming down the river now. It's blowing my umbrella about like crazy. I wouldn't want to be out on one of those boats, I can assure you. So they've started to come down now, the boats. This is the lunchtime rush. We usually get them in the morning, lunchtime, and in the evening. Straight over the top, nice swim. But carp are used to that, like I say. They just get out of the way. So it's quite cold along here, I'll tell you, with that wind, it's really, really blowing. And it doesn't take long when you're standing out there start freezing, so I'm staying behind here. So I'm counting that fish as a winter fish for sure. But it's not a bad day though, you know, overcast, a little bit of sunlight creeping through cracks here and there, but generally speaking it's pretty dull. I'm still surprised that that inside rod went away. I mean, you know, I've had fish from the inside line here before, over there obviously, but you know, sort of chuck it in the margins, isn't it, really? Nowhere else to put it, chuck it in the margins. But, you know, it worked. I thought about it. I put the 1 ounce lead on, I put the pop-up on. I used half boilies that they floated on top of the weed. So I'm quite happy with that fish. Quite happy. I put in the effort and I got a reward. So, you never know. One of those could go off again. We've got a couple of hours at least. Let's have a look at the time, see what the time is, shall we? 2:17. So I'd say we've got maximum of 2 hours fishing left. Starts to get dark just around 4 o'clock, so that'll be when I'm going. Well, it's chillier than a fridge here, I'll tell you. It's 3:15, so I've got about another half an hour or so left. Good, because I'm freezing. Like I said, I want to go home and get warm. And get a nice hot cup of coffee down me. I've had a couple of cups of tea, but running out of gas now, so I better get another one of those as well. So this is my last session this week. I've had 3 sessions. Fairly full days and a short session. Lost one, landed one, so not too bad. I'll put some bait in when I go, come back tomorrow on Sunday, and probably Monday too after work, just to slip in a few handfuls, and try and get down Tuesday.
If not, then Monday night I'll stick in half a key a kilo. That should do. And I'll put some on this side as well. Well, I've had enough. I'm absolutely froze up my arse here. I don't have any winter kit on. I've still got to get some winter kit for this year. And I bloody need it, I tell you. It's real cold out here. I've got long johns, pair of trousers and my over trousers on. Waterproof over trousers. Fleece, a hoodie, this jacket, a t-shirt. And I'm still freezing. And I'm sat behind the umbrella as well. So. It's 20 to 4, quarter to 4, so I've pretty much given it my best shot. I've had a fish, I'm happy. Yesterday's bat is not a fish. That's debris on the line. I've got debris on the line on the two rods over on the prime spot. I say the prime spot because it hasn't gone today, has it? Just goes to show you. Yeah, no, I've caught a few fish from over there, so, yeah. I have to be honest, I was hoping to do a little bit better, you know, in a way. But there doesn't seem to be that many fish along this stretch. Like I say, when I've been here, I've only seen a couple of fish, you know, but I have seen a fish every time I've come here. When I was fishing here in the summer, there was only, as far as I could see, seven different fish, although possibly two others which I did catch a glimpse of now and then, but never really identified properly, although one of them was a mid-20 common, I'm pretty sure of that. So there's obviously a few that I haven't caught, there always is, but, well, I mean, I counted seven fish and caught seven, and, you know. And of course, the recapture of bully, that one there, I think I've had that before, I'm pretty sure. I'll have a look. So, yeah. I'm going to keep at it for another while. I don't know how much longer. I mean, next week, like I say, I might not be able to get out fishing much. Working again next week as well. But I will keep trickling the bait, and with any luck, we'll get a few sessions on here and pull something else out. But if not, I've enjoyed the last three sessions. You know, it's been all right. It's an adventure, isn't it? And I really enjoy this kind of fishing. Setting it up all myself. You know, fishing areas where no one else fishes, it's all down to me. Finding the spots, getting the bait in, getting the fish out, you know. It's the best kind of fishing, really. My hand's starting to bloody freeze holding this camera, so I'm going to pack my kit away slowly. Those rods will be the last thing to come out. I'll rest them on the ground when I'm taking all the kit apart. And you never know.